Here on BBC One, forget the looks, it's the personality that counts.
I put a nickel in the telephone.
A trip to America.
A trip to America? Hey, wouldn't that be fantastic?
There's no chance whatsoever of winning the national contest.
Oh, why not?
Little dreamers are fruity. The national winners are almost always home counties girls with the right accents.
Jersey, isn't that where the honeymooners go?
Don't ask me. The cheek of it.
What's up, Val?
This.
The following have been selected to represent Derby Exchange in the first round of the Miss Telephone Personality. Miss A. Armitage, Miss C. Cross, Miss S. Sands. Signed, Miss D. and Marriott, head supervisor.
Two pets and one for the pot, I'd say.
Without a word of consultation.
Chris, she's got the oom for it. Sylvia, I suppose, because it's in the family. Didn't her sister win it years ago?
Yeah, but I reckon she's only been put in there to make up the numbers.
But fancy choosing Armitage.
You stand a better chance than her, Ron.
Thanks.
Mmm. Nice and buttery.
If one were lucky enough to win. I know exactly where I'd head for. The Rockies, the Grand Canyon, John Wayne country. Do you really think I stand a chance?
Stand a chance? You'll breeze through. I wouldn't have put you up for it if I'd thought otherwise.
I do feel so flattered to have been selected after all these years. Thank you, Dolly. I know many these days prefer the younger candidates.
As far as I'm concerned, it's a matter of principle. Girls in tight swimsuits and bright lipstick are not my idea of the image we should be conveying.
I do have a swimsuit.
The contest should be won on good breeding and brains, rather than exposed cleavage and fluttering eyelashes.
Connecting you, Darlington. You do know what's required of you, don't you, for the contest?
General knowledge and good grooming, isn't it?
Handicapper of Rhodesia, that kind of stuff. National emblem of New Zealand.
Kangaroo, isn't it?
It's a kiwi.
Of course.
There's usually a test on exchanges as well.
You could do those with a sack over your head, Chris.
It's a general knowledge that's a bother, and technical procedure.
That's where Annie Armitage has the advantage.
She shouldn't be in it anyway by rights. We've been properly consulted.
Nobody ever takes any interest in it anyway.
Only because it's reckoned to be a foregone conclusion, and that's all wrong.
I'm just socking at you.
I don't agree. Chris and Sylvia have got just as much chance.
I'm more than willing to take bets on it.
The ice cream on this. Miss Pepper?
Trying to connect to you.
I received your note. My response is that if its purpose was to promulgate dissension against a most popular decision...
Not at all, Miss Marriott.
Is it that you wish to be entered? Or Miss Ferrari, perhaps?
It's just that the girls would have appreciated a degree of consultation.
Very well. You are being consulted now, Miss Pepper. You can be on the selection jury.
See? My note did nudge management into action. She'll think twice next time.
You clearly terrified the life out of the valley pot.
Something wonderful has happened, Rick. I've been selected as a contender for the telephone personality girl.
For what?
If I win the Derby Heat, I can go in the national contest. Rick, it's a trip to America. It's my chance to travel.
Travel? What do you mean?
My chance to escape. Break the monotony. Get out of Derby. You won't be here. You'll be too busy studying to be something clever in Oxford. But you could help me win the contest. It would transform my whole life.
So, that's 2-1 on Armitage, 5-1 on.
Is this for charity?
It's for my holiday. Want to cover yourself with a bob or two on Sylvia in case Miss Armitage fails?
What do you take me for? Annie Armitage will win for no other reason than she's been put up for it by Miss Marriott. And you know that as well as every GPO employee in Derby.
She might develop nerves.
And you might develop wings.
Oh, Dick! Chris has been nominated for Telephone Personality Girl, did she tell you? But she won't take it seriously.
It's up to her, isn't it?
Everyone's betting on Miss Armitage to win, even though she's 5-1 on.
I would as well if I wasn't in it.
You've got a chance.
I put 2 bob on you to win.
2 bob? You're a chump, Jim. I've a good mind to make Ronnie return it.
I don't want it back.
Taking money off a young lad.
You see, Ronnie reckons Miss Armitage will win, because she's the one with a clever head. But, as I said to Bert, as long as there's blokes on the panel, Chris is a winner. See, it doesn't matter that you've got no brains. It's what happens in the vet department that...
Ronnie? Miss Armitage isn't going to win it. My book says she is. You've got it wrong. I am. No chance, Chris.
A private word.
All right.
I'm waiting all week for your answer, Chris. It's not fair to keep me dangling.
I need time.
Time for some stupid quiz?
You want me to win, don't you, Dick?
I'm asking you to marry me, and you're talking about bloody quizzes.
No, I'm talking about me.
You don't know what you want.
I know what I don't want.
Well, good luck to you.
Ruthie, you've got some real competition. I'm going to try and win the contest.
Oh, good. Is it the trip to America you're after?
No, I won't get that far. Local prize will do for me.
It's not a bad prize. Jersey's a lovely place.
I'm not really interested in the prize. I just want to prove something to certain people around here.
Never you mind, Poppet. Jersey will still be there next year.
I can keep Jersey. It's a trip to America, am I?
You're making a dreadful noise right now. Number, please.
Miss Ferrari, are you actually singing on duty?
If I am, Miss Marriott, it's only because I'm happy.
We are not employed here to be happy, Miss Ferrari. We are employed here to concentrate on our work.
Remember that, girls, when the panel asks you if you enjoy your work, we are not here to be happy.
Connect your
number, please. What is your number, please? Who else is on the panel?
Reggie Harrison from HQ.
Chris has got a chance there.
He could never resist a blonde with legs.
Reggie Harrison, that old goat, are you certain? Anyone else we know?
Miss Marriott. Mr. Allison, you know, Mr. Brain's Trust from the old service. And that stuck up Miss Bradley.
Bottom's in the frantic up.
Mm.
exchanges beginning with A.
Alstonfield, Ambergate, Ashbourne, Ashby-de-la-Zouche.
That's four. It doesn't do to show off.
Sorry, got carried away.
Well, I don't think there's any point in continuing. As far as practices and procedures go, you are a walking encyclopedia. There will be no one to touch you, Annie.
I have been boning up.
Of course, one can't take anything for granted. Miss Cross is hardly a Brain of Britain material. Miss Sands has yet to emerge from her pubescent cocoon. But we do have Valerie Pepper on the panel. And, more importantly, Reggie Harrison to contend with now.
Oh, but Miss Pepper, I'm sure, will be entirely fair-minded. And Reggie, why, we've known each other for years and years.
Quite. Incidentally, it might not be a bad idea to have something up one's sleeve in the way of a poem or a song. It may well be requested.
Who betrayed the Russian Revolution? That's not the sort of question they're going to ask.
All right, keep your hair on. Right, let's see. Describe a trisoctahedron.
You're doing it on purpose.
I'll give you a clue. It's quite interesting, actually. Sylvia, control your temper.
We're not looking for Einstein. I forget your cleverness and help me for a change.
What's your favourite hobby?
Strangling big heads.
Joy had to recite a poem. Is there anyone there? Asked the traveller. She got it down to a T. All that's required in the first round is that you talk in the proper fashion, like you were taught at the elocution class. Ducks are dabbling, uptails all, the way they do on the radio.
Queen's English. I can do that.
My husband and I. Richard, stand on a chair and fetch me down that box, will you? That one? This all the stuff that Joy did when she won it. All her notes on it.
Mum, I don't need advice and I don't need Joy's notes.
You do if you intend to win.
I can win on my own, thanks.
Ducks are dabbling, up tails all.